Hello and welcome everybody, this is Yanaman and Cyrex bringing you a Fleet Ops audio commentary. Cyrex, please do say hi.
Hey everyone.
Cool, alright, so we have a 2v2, Star Traffic, versus, you know, it's Big Bad Beef and Old Time Pro versus Cam K and Warp Core. So let me give you an introduction to who is who. So up here as the orange Klingons, this here is Cam K. His teammate for the evening is as the teal Borg. This is Warp Core. Down here in the bottom, as we wait for Cyrex to figure out what he's doing over there in his computer, as the red Federation, this is Beef. And Beef's teammate for the evening, as Old Time Pro, is the purple Dominion. Ah, dang it, Romulan. You know what? I'm going to shoot whoever changes their color, race, name, anything when I'm taking notes. So, Cyrex, how are you doing tonight?
Oh, I'm doing just fine. It's a bit late, but ready for a game.
Excellent. So, okay. So, we got these players. What the hell are they doing?
Well, they all seem to be in their pretty typical standard startups.
So, okay, I'm looking at Old TP, and I see Shrikes out on the board. Why am I seeing Shrikes? He's got a Borg opponent, and he's got a Klingon opponent. Why would he be doing Shrikes?
Well, that beats me. I'm just sort of observing the other guys right now.
So, it's the only thing I can think of is he is going to be facing small vessels, the Quebec. He's hoping, perhaps, that someone's going to pause the game right now, and so I'm going to pause the recording. Okay, Shrikes. Now Beef is all better. He feels much more relaxed. Okay, so Shrikes versus Borg. Not so great. I don't think they're just going to do much. Maybe he's going against the Klingons, the Quebecs, yada, yada, yada. Okay, let's take a look at Red. What is Red doing? Red is fed. Red has ship chassis level 1 up already. He is setting up his second storage dock. By and large, it is as pretty much of an optimal fed build as you could possibly ask for, and Beef is just doing the same. Chassis level 1 up, star yard up right now. What do you think? Monsoons. Okay, he's facing Borg. He's facing Klingons. I am thinking just a crap ton of Intrepids. What do you think?
Yeah, they'd be a pretty solid unit against his opponents.
Okay, yeah, but look at this.
Monsoons.
The Monsoons! Why? What long-range vessel is going to come out in the next 15 minutes that would require a monsoon?
Maybe
yeah, my point exactly. So, Quebecs, medium range, Intrepids. ADAI, it'd be great, but no. Okay, so we're going to call Beef silly for a little bit. You know, just for a little bit. Unless he's expecting the board to go dodecahedrons.
Oh, Beat, our camp, always a fan of running down the Federation scouts.
Yeah, true, true, true. And, oh yeah, gotta love the new Dug. Yeah, the new Dug class, it does a great job. And then the feds are gonna run into a shield regenerating nebula, and their shields are gonna last for freaking ever. Well, you know what? Nine versus... oh god, Scout Wars.
Riveting.
This is just, you know what? You know what? Someone could bash their head into a rock longer than someone could watch this. I mean, this is like watching a new duck try to take out a resource assimilator.
Well, the first monsoon is on the field, and right. Looks like he's switching over to Intrepids.
Okay, so. And up here, we still got Quebecs. Okay, so what is Borg doing? So Borg is energy nose level 2. Hello. That'll be interesting. So that means that Borg is not going skew brush. He's going to wait around, maybe for a single skew. Maybe as long as a sphere? That would be crazy. So that's going to leave Cam K with all of the responsibility for the next 15 minutes to field offensive vessels. Romulans are going strikes and Levals. He's got a pair of strikes going up against. Oh, okay, and there is a Scube here. So there's a Scube out on the board. That's great. And there are strikes out on the board versus a Scube. Not so great. So OTP is not an idiot most of the time. I would not expect him to decloak here. But what are all these strikes doing? Does he know something that we don't?
It would certainly seem that way. The board are throwing up a dode.
Okay, so Dode, so there's that monsoon coming out in handy already. And are we going for. So I don't see any. No Starfleet science, so therefore no Starfleet command, therefore no warp-ins. So. And we have the Klingons expanding towards the middle. So. Cam K making a. Actually, a really strong move. Okay, so wow. Okay, so these strikes going after this scout cube, and look
And
how,
not doing bad, yeah.
and not doing bad at all. I mean, that scout cube is going to knock one of those off. These got these strikes have some nice. Wow, that's impressive. That they did really, really well. I'm actually quite impressed there. And Axial Assault going just haywire on these guys. Pushing those guys back. And okay, so Teal Warp Core needs to not engage his ship that is about to die. Does anyone. Okay, Warp Core really needs to not engage the ship that is about to die because it's about to die. Here comes another Doty. Okay, am I reading that right at 2% hull?
Oh, escapes just by the hull plating.
The hair of its skinny skin.
Yeah.
Okay,
Seeing good
so.
use of the nebulas.
Jeesh. Pair of Dodes, a scout cube that won't be around for a long, long time. Unfortunately, he can't decloak that scout that's sitting right in the middle of his base. Romulans are getting their butt back into the repair yard because they've got a life support that's dead. Alright, so. We have a Fed, we have a Romulan, they're facing a Klingon Borg fleet. Opponents. Borg are going Dodes, Klingon are going Kvetch. And they are expanding to the middle, and we have a nice little field research off way off in the corner. We are expecting Cavorts here shortly because those monsoons will not do. Monsoons and the Intrepids will not do crap against Cavorts. Because Gavorts are short range, and the Borg are going to go long range. So, what do these guys do? They're going Levals, which is nice. And the Feds are continuing to go Intrepids, as far as I can tell. So, what do they do? What should we expect? Double yarding Intrepids.
Well, that's certainly gonna do. It's throwing a lot of torpedoes out there, that's for sure.
So, lots of torpedoes, which is nice. And we are getting crap tons of Kvorts from Cam K. And, you know, I've seen this from Cam. Cam loves Kvorts. For whatever reason, he likes it. And he's good with them, too. But he also has a decent amount of Quebec's out on the field already, which is nice. And Cam is really just slowly building up a nasty, nasty fleet. So are we looking at... What are we looking at? We are looking at Sousa. So this is a Martok. Beef is going for Starfleet Science. So he is insinuating that he's going after Starfleet Command. Get some warp-ins. At this point,
well, it looks like Borg and Klingons are on the move.
Okay, where are the Borg? Where did the Borg go?
Bottom right corner of the map.
Bottom right corner of the Borg, and the Klingons are moseying right around. You see that? Beef is bringing up... So... The scout is doing a heck of a job against these Borg guys there. You know, it's tailing that guy, and for whatever reason, Teal Warp Core is feeling a little bit uncomfortable, so he is retreating. It's almost like he knows what's coming up.
Well, you gotta love scout has been following the Fed fleet as well.
Yeah, true. So he knows that they know that he's coming over there, and... Here they come. There's going after this Dode, and this Dode is dead. Basically, it is kaput. Okay, it's not kaput yet, but there it goes. Here comes the Klingons, and the Klingons are making their presence felt. Wow. So who won that one? Definitely the Borg did not come out very well. Warp is hurting. Lost a 15 collective connections off on that Dode. I think there was, a Romulan ship that got whacked. And so, honestly, that's a pretty decent trade. All right. So what do you do here? You've just lost a ship. What do you expect is going to happen next?
I think we're going to see another beating on the Borg here.
I think you're absolutely right, because the Romulans and the Fed decided to just party on them. And here comes the Klingons. Those medium-range ships are beating the crap out of that monsoon, rightly so. And why are we transporting... Why are we transporting on a monsoon that is about to die? Seriously? Ugh. Down goes a Dodi, just right there. And the Borg are really taking a lot of... They're taking a crap ton of damage. So that bottom team is auto-targeting the Borg here. To great effect. And Cam K, how is he doing on his micro? He is getting this guy. Is he going to get this guy out? Oh my god! Cam K with the micro at 10%. Nice. Very well, well played. Well played. And he gets a Romulan kill. And he's going to get an Intrepid kill, despite the fact that the ADAI is negating his medium range damage. Something to be said about numbers, eh?
Mm-hmm. Sure makes for a long trip back home.
Yeah, it does. So, we have... No warp-ins yet. Shrikes, Laval's. Klingons are getting a little bit paranoid with their scout stations. It's quite nice. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. Those things are cheap too. I mean, you can almost litter the board with them. I mean, so what?
If someone,
yeah, right. You just put them on the corners, and they catch so much stuff. Ooh, some Cavorts out on the board. I love me some Cavorts. You know, Cavorts are one of my favorite ships. And you know why? See, this is where you ask me why.
Oh, all right. So this is where you're going to tell me why.
Yes, yes. Right now, it's because they get that freaking engine hooks. It's like, that is one of the most valuable passives in the game is in engine hooks. Whatever the race-specific name for it is, if you can whack the engines, you can get kills. And by God, the Cavorts do some hellacious killing in that regard.
Speaking of killing, in the center of the map, we've got another conflict.
Oh, dear lord, the Romulans do not look like they are faring well, but quite frankly, neither do the Borg. The Borg are about to lose their Scoob, and the Klingons are about to wipe up on some stuff. Looks like OTP is going to get out with his Laval, and the Borg are not going to get out with anything. So Cam is actually fielding a nice little fleet there. Really doing a great job of just getting the numbers, but he needs to not die here.
It's also turned into a two-front conflict for Cam. He's raiding the Federation base as we speak.
Oh, dear lord. Why is he taking Starbase fire? That's kind of silly. He needs to split his consciousness, like, in three places. Because otherwise, taking Starbase fire is about the dumbest things you could do. See, look, even Cam agrees with this. His ships were doing great as far as being stupid. Is he going to get this Cavort out? No! The Intrepids get within short range and are going to blow it up. So much for the Cavorts, eh? Nothing like free ranks to your opponents.
Federation could use all the free ranks they can get right now.
Look how many Intrepids they have. They've got about 10 on the bottom. They've got about none on the top. And two up going on to the above, where we're going to see a heavy weapons platform? Dear lord.
The Romulans have also set up a warbird yard.
Sexy, sexy, but they've only got like 300 dilithium. So, I don't know what AltTP is thinking, other than warbird, warbird, warbird. He needs to think a little bit dilithium, dilithium, dilithium. Alright, so we have some Katingas out here trying to allow... Oh, nope, not going to happen. These Intrepids have successfully shut down that... well, also with the Lavals, have successfully shut down that heavy weapons platform. Quite nice.
What's this? Camp's expansion? We have a diamond on the field.
What? Hello! Hi, Diamond! Where did you come from?
I don't know, but I would not want to be those Intrepids right now.
No, dear lord. Dear lord, that diamond... Okay, does he have it? Does he have nanites anytime soon? Okay, I don't see the transmission matrix, so no nanites. Nonetheless, DPS diamonds are ugly. Microtech, and what has he got? Yep. Got a full DPS guy, and what is this Cavort doing? Being stupid. Okay, let's look at the size of Cam K's fleet. Cam K has got 2, 4, 6, 8, 12, 14. Somewhere between 14 and 16. Quebecs. Well, with a Cavort in there. That's kind of nice!
The Federation fleet is shrinking at a steady rate.
That's negative growth is a bad thing. That diamond's That diamond's hilarious. Who needs a sphere when you can go straight to diamonds? OTP is just kind of like hanging around, doing the scouting thing, you know, whatever. Monsoons, and here comes that Starfleet command. Give it about another 90 seconds, and we'll have some warp ins. Who needs dilithium when you can get your ships for free? Oh, dear lord. Laval's going into the sensor scout station. Not that the Laval's really care, considering there's nothing there.
Talk about overstaying your welcome.
Yeah, talk about it. Like, bad idea. If that Laval gets out, that'll be hilarious. Okay, that is hilarious. That guy does not deserve to live. No, wait, give it time. It's going to commit suicide. Okay, I can picture OTP like just swearing as many languages as he knows.
Mouse clicking is furiously clicking away, the keyboard's clicking.
Banging it against the computer monitor. God dang it! So Purple, OTP, how many ships does he have now? Because right now he's got like a Silar coming out, and that's about it. And there are Cavorts in his base here shortly. Oh, buddy, gotta love a Cavort.
Cavort.
Yep. Nope, it's gonna get in. Total waste of firepower. They should, you know, whack on these miners, which they are doing to do. Ah, gotta love it. Cavorts are one of my favorite.
Is the second diamond is now coming up, and nanites is being researched.
Wait a minute, what? How? Jesus, who is letting the Borg have that much free time? I mean, besides the fact that Cam is just spamming the hell out of these Quebecs, and he's got even a vet Quebec. Right? Feds. Intrepid fleet with some warpins. You know, respectable. Cavorts eating away at pretty much everything. Solar.
Even going after the mining station now.
Yeah. Can I stutter a little bit more? Because that seems like a silly thing. I mean, why not take out the miners when you can get, why not get kills in rank-ups when you can get kills in rank-ups? These guys are gonna whack on this guy. Are they really seriously gonna get that station? They're gonna get the station.
Perhaps the strategy is to frustrate old time pro into submission.
Well, you know, I mean, if he's cursing, he's not killing you. So Beef is messing around with the field research. And there are so many Cavorts that it's not even, doesn't even matter anymore. That diamond is crazy, but so is his Fed fleet. And here we have the fun stuff. And down goes the Quebec. Here comes the diamond. Do we have nanites? Do we have nanites now? Because that would be just ugly. Guess what? We do have nanites. That is going to hurt. That's just going to hurt a little bit.
It's getting ugly.
That's going to be ugly. That is quite ugly, actually. And the feds, they're running like they should be, because that sucks.
We got a veteran Quebec leading the way.
I know, right? It's just totally soaking up fire. and it is just laughing. I mean, you know, Klingons laughing is kind of silly. Insofar as you don't tell that to them, their face.
Couldn't have picked a worse ship to target.
Yeah, exactly, right? Let me... Yeah. Yeah, Beef is not having a good day right now because, quite frankly, he is getting outnumbered like about 3-1 with a diamond. With nanites. Because that kind of sucks. And Kamgay is... making about face. Almost going to get a kill. This Monsoon is actually going to get away. And the Fed is actually doing a really good job of dealing damage and getting back into repair. So, got to give it to Beef, who is cycling repair quite nicely. Except for this poor Excelsior that is going to get his butt kicked, which it did. Oh, those Excel ones, they're so freaking fragile and slow and, gotta love them. Good old nanites.
Suppose the Federation has switched over to entirely Monsoons at both their yards.
Well, I mean, because you're dealing with a diamond, that diamond just does so much freaking damage. Though, I mean, you still got the Quebec, and so its ADAI is quite nice to soak up some damage. So I really don't know. Warpins, perhaps, just get some DPS on the board. Gotta get some kills, because otherwise they're just gonna Klingon rule you. You gotta love how Cam is taking the entire middle here. He has managed to set up shop in his middle expansion. He's managed to set up shop in Old Time Pro's middle expansion. And he's got all these tons of scout stations on. I love scout stations. And I love how the fact that they're mixing big versus small. So, yeah, quite nice.
The Galaxy class arrives.
That's unfortunate. That guy, as far as I can tell, is a fragile little punk. He does some great damage when you rank him up. You know, basically an automatic shield breaking torpedo, but I'll tell you, get him up there. He tends to take a lot of damage. It almost seems that you always end up facing an opponent with torpedoes, and so those torpedoes just end up doing a heck of a lot of damage. So OTP has a pair of Stellars, and it really feels like he's playing on a defensive beat right now. He's got long-range ships. If he can snag one, is he? Let's see if he's got the special. No special. So it really feels like, you know, tell me your opinion here, but the top team is winning this game right now about 75% to 25%.
I have to concur with that assessment.
I mean, let's see. We've got a fleet of about, 15, 16 Quebec, so about 8 Kaborts, each of them in their own right, kind of nasty. Beef has bottled himself up. He's got he's got his turtling phaser platforms down in the expansion, 3 of them. Has sunk in a decent amount of resources in order to do that. Versus his opponent, who has really gone straight offensive units, allows him mobility, firepower, mobility, and firepower. And we have
this might be interesting. The Klingon fleet is out of position, and the Federation fleet is approaching.
And the Federation fleet is stopping. I'm agreeing with you here, but they're giving the the Klingons' camp get all the time in the world to do something else. I don't know where he's going. Oh, I know where he's going.
He's trying to pump more rage out of old time P.
I know, right? Trying to teach him a couple new languages of cursing. Solar almost out, about 20 seconds. And the feds have done nothing but insinuate. Insinuation. Oh, they're going to wait for that guy to come out. Oh, no. They should wait for him to come out. They should wait. And out it comes. Now they should kill it. And they're not going to get to, unfortunately. That's just nasty fleet. You know, I love fleets. My definition of fleet is something more than 20. That's almost more than 20. So the feds, they know where that Klingon fleet is, and so they are going to waltz into this base, and they're going to try to take out whatever they can.
Yep, there it is. Camp is always a fan of Katingas.
Yep. Of course, in this point in time, this many feds are just going to get rank-ups on it. Though, of course, they're going to get rank-ups regardless, because they're going to kill stuff. Might as well do a little damage with some Katingas. Oddly enough, this galaxy is deciding to waltz away. Getting a little bit of kill going on, a little bit of experience. And here comes the two diamonds.
Oh, those graviton torpedoes, they really hurt.
They really do. I mean, they hit you and they just really blow you the hell out of the water. It's like an E1 takes two and is dead. Just catching engines. Oh, a little bit of rank up getting engine caught. Time to go home. Oh, another engine caught. Gotta hate the diamond. Oh, what those diamonds are doing.
We have a third diamond on the map.
Okay, Warp Core is just being just evil. Nice, catching them a little bit of engines. Oddly enough, doesn't seem to affect the Laval too much. Of course, some monsoons, even with their high-density shield generators, that goes from not, you know, just hull to no hull whatsoever.
The Klingon siege in the Romulan space.
Oh yeah, they're doing a number on Old Time Pro. you don't really need your research station. We shall take it from you. And the feds are trying to get a leg up on this diamond, which, if they could actually get the kill, would be pretty awesome. Which, they might actually get the kill. Check that out. They are going to get the diamond kill. Wait. What just happened there? Okay, that thing ducked into a nebula? Okay, finally, thank you. They're actually gonna get two diamond kills out of this thing. Even though there's a third diamond on the wings.
Speaking of wings, the cavorts are coming in.
Oh yeah, that's gonna be ugly. Bye bye, Galaxy. Bye bye, Monsoons. And OTP is GGing? Well, yeah, that makes sense. Well, appreciate the co-commentary there, dude.
Yeah, thanks, Yandan. It was quite amusing to watch.
Yes, it was. All right, folks, Yandan signing off. Please give feedback, comments, suggestions on strategy, or just say hi. And, you know, welcome to the Fleet Ops community if you are new here. And, you know, feel free to join us online. It's Yandan signing off. See you on the flip side.